या गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। या क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ स्टोन्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल दिस क्लासिफिकेशंस राइट, इग्नीशियस, सेडिमेंटरी, मेटामॉर्फिक एंड स्ट्रेटिफाइड, अनस्ट्रेटिफाइड, पोलिएटेड, सिलिशियस, अर्जिलिशियस एंड कैल्क्रीशियस। दिस इज द क्लासिफिकेशन। अगेन इग्नीशियस रॉक इज डिवाइडेड इनटू डिफरेंट टाइप्स राइट। दिस इज द वन ऑफ टाइप, वन ऑफ द इग्नीशियस रॉक। ओके, इफ यू हैव सीन there are small granules. Okay, these are all made up of with granules right, very compact granules. Okay, igneous rock is made up of compact granules. Next is sedimentary rocks. We have discussed sedimentary rocks right. This is metamorphic rock, stratified, unstratified, foliated, argillaceous. Argy means clay right. Yeah, calcareous, that containing calcium carbonate as a major ingredient. Siliceous rock, silica is a major ingredient in this siliceous rock. And we have started the stone quarrying right, the process of extraction of a stone from their natural rock right, rock beds is known as quarrying of stone. Nothing but just taking the stone from the rock, very simple word right. This is a quarry right. From quarry stones are available. From stones we can crush that stone and make into a aggregate, quartz aggregate, that is using in the construction of a building right. This one also site selection for a stone quarry, this one also we have completed up to now. In this methods of stone quarrying, how a stone is removed from its parent material. What is the parent material? That is rock. What are the different methods? Hand tool method, machine quarrying and blasting. We have seen the excavating, heating and wedging in the hand tool method right. Yesterday we have seen the how wedging is done right, keeping the steel points and hitting with a hammer, the rock will get the stone will get divided from the other stone into small pieces right, wedging. Yeah, today we'll discuss about machine quarrying. Okay, machine quarrying, in that we have used hand tools. Okay, we have kept steel points and we have hit that steel points with the hammer right. It is a time taking process, so human power is required, but here machine, we are using machine quarrying. So machine quarrying is done by using channel machines right. This type of machine is driven by steam, compressed air or electricity. Which this machine is driven by either steam or compressed air or electricity. Mostly nowadays electricity is available every place right. So nowadays a machine quarrying is done by using electricity right. Yeah, steam is olden days process, steam and compressed air. So the recent technology is based on electricity right. Yeah, how the quarrying is done. Okay, how a quarrying is done by using this machine, channeling machine. Okay, channeling machine will make grooves all around the rock and horizontal holes are drilled underneath the block. Okay, first you just check the picture, then you can get an idea what is a groove. Okay, what is a groove, how this channeling machine is doing this groove. Okay, so first observe the picture. You see the first picture and second picture. Okay, in the second picture you see it is cutting the stone. Okay, in the form of a groove. Okay, what is mean by groove means, you see this is a V groove. Is it clear? This is a V groove, this is a U shaped groove. Okay, here it is doing a V shaped groove right. You observe here. Okay, you observe this place. Okay, it is doing a V shaped groove. So in this process it will cut the stone from its parent material right. Is it clear? So if you want a big square stone, so it will make right a square cut, a square shape cut. If you see, if this is a rock, okay, you want to just take a rectangle shape. So it will cut here, and it will cut here, and it will cut here, right? It will make a groove shape. Okay, after that, what will happen? From bottom, holes will be drilled. Okay, from bottom. Now it is doing at top. Okay, groove is made at top. But after making the groove, what they will do? They will drill the holes at the bottom, exactly below the groove. Okay, exactly below the groove. At that time, what will happen? The stone will get separated from the parent rock. These holes will be made from the bottom, exactly below the groove. Right? Are you getting the point? Yeah. So by this method, they will be getting the stones from the rock, from the parent material. Right? Is it clear how the stone is getting by using a channeling machine? Now we'll see how much length will be the groove, and how much width will be the groove, and how much depth will be the groove. Yeah, right? If you just check that, you can understand. You see a large groove of 24 meter length. Okay, 24 meters length and 50 to 75 mm width. Okay, 50 to 75 mm width means 7.5 centimeters. 5 to 7.5 centimeters width. So it's a small width, but the length of the groove is more, right? And what is the depth of the groove? 2 to 3.7 meters. Okay, if you see, length will be more, depth will be 2 to 3.7 meters. So you will obtain a big stone, right? 24 meter length stone that is having a depth of 3.7 meters. So you can dress that stone into, you can dress that stone into any shape, right? If you are having a big block of stone, you can do anything. You can carve anything on that stone, right? Yeah. So larger blocks of stones can be obtained using this method. So 24 meter length and 3.7 meter depth means it will be a big block, right? So by using this channeling machine, we can obtain a large block of stones, right? Big stones will be coming from that channeling machine. Okay, which type of stone can be quarried by using this machine, right? By using this machine, which types of stones can be quarried? Marbles, limestone, etc. are quarried using this machine quarrying. Okay, which types of stones they are quarrying? Marbles, limestone. Is it clear? Yeah. Next one. Okay, these are the channeling machines, right? These are the channeling machines. Now, quarrying by hand tools and quarrying by machine is completed. Now, next point is quarrying of stone by blasting. Okay, quarrying of stone by blasting. In this method, explosives are used to separate the stones from parent rock. Okay, what they will use? Explosives. Okay, dynamites, right? Bombs. They'll use that one to separate the stone from the parent rock. What they will do? They will make holes. Okay, just listen. They will make holes. In that holes, they will drop the bombs, right? Explosives. Okay, what happen if this explosives explode? Okay, the stone will get separated from the parent rock, right? Yes, we'll see what they will do in the quarrying of stone by blasting. In the blasting process, what they will do? This process is applied in case of hard stone or hard rock. Okay, when there is a hard stone, example, granite is a igneous rock, which is very hard stone, right? Or hard rock, anything, hard stone or hard rock. which does not contain any cracks or fissures, right? In a igneous rock, no cracks will be there, right? It is a uniform mass of rock, right? So it does not contain any cracks or fissures. So it is a hard stone or hard rock, right? The holes are drilled in the rock, right? The holes are drilled and explosives are arranged in the hole. Okay, holes will be drilled, and if it is a big rock, okay, if it is a big rock, holes will be drilled, right? In these holes, the explosives are arranged. Is it clear? Explosives are arranged, right? Here I have drawn a big one, but the holes are drilled and the explosives are arranged in the holes and blasted. Okay, they will blast that explosives with proper safety measures. So they will give information to all the surroundings. Okay, as there is a blasting, they will inform all the surrounding people. Okay, not to go that side. Okay, these all information will be given in advance. Okay, during blasting, no one will be coming that site, right? Next, the stones obtained through this process are not large in size because of the blasting. What will happen? Because of the blasting, the stones are exploded and they have formed into a small pieces, right? So large size of blocks are not available in this blasting process, right? So the main purpose of blasting is to obtain small stones which are used as ballast for railway works, aggregate in concrete works, etc. The stones that is available from the blasting, okay, the stone that is available from the blasting are used for the ballast for railway work. What is mean by this ballast? Ballast means railway track will be there. Under the railway track, stones will be there. That is called ballast, right? That is called ballast. And aggregate in concrete work. In the foundation, you see, a pit will be dug, right? A pit will be dug. Now, what they will do? They will, at the bottom of the house, okay? At the bottom of the house, this is a ground surface, okay? This is a ground surface, okay? For the foundation purpose, they have dig a big pit, right? At the bottom of the pit, we have to lay the foundation, right? We have to lay the foundation. Before laying of foundation, what they will do? They will keep the aggregate, okay? At the bottom, they will keep the aggregate, okay? First, they will throw the aggregate into this pit. After that, what they will do? They will pour cement and water mixture. Cement water mixture. Okay, they will pour cement water mixture in this pit. Okay, they will pour cement water mixture. Right. This is filled with cement water mixture. Right. So here a uniform surface is provided for the foundation. Right. On this, they can lay the first footing, second footing, third footing, right? So in the concrete construction work, they will use this blasted aggregate, right? As during the blasting, the aggregate, the stones are blasted in small pieces. That's why they use that small pieces in this type of works, right? Is it clear? Yeah. Next, you see small stones they have obtained, small. So this is a blasting area, right? After blasting, these stones are formed, okay? So they are obtained in small pieces, not big pieces. So they have used in the different types of works, right? Right. Next one, precautions. Precautions in blasting. What are the different precautions that we have to take? Okay, in blasting. So Blasting should not be carried out in late evening or early mornings. Okay, blasting should not be carried out in late evenings or early mornings. Right, the blasting hours should be made public, and a siren should warn the workmen and nearby public timely to retire to a safe distance. Okay, as I said before, what we have to do? We have to give sirens, right? So that they will understand, oh, siren is coming, so here some blasting is going on, so we should not go to that particular site. We have to be in a safe place for some time. Okay, after blasting we can go, but during blasting time we have to be in a safe place, right? So it should not be carried in late evenings or early mornings hours, right? Next, the danger zone, an area of about 200 meter radius, should be marked with red flag. Okay, around the site, okay, from where the blasting is conducting, around the 200 meters radius, we have to mark the mark with the red flags. Okay, red flag should be planted, right? Why? Because they will understand, so here red flags are there, so some danger is there, so we should not go that side, right? So different sign conventions will be there, so they will protect themselves from this blasting, right? Yeah, next, first aid should be available. Okay, some persons will be there, they will they might not be aware of this all signs, and they have gone near the blasting. If something happens, there should be first aid to treat that person, right? There should be first aid to treat the person immediately, right? Next, the number of charges fired, the number of charges exploded, and the misfires should be recorded. Okay, what we have to record? The number of charges fired, okay, the number of charges exploded, and the misfires should be recorded. Okay, if you have kept 10 dynamites, okay, 10 dynamites in the 10 poles, okay, you have charged 10 dynamites, okay, 8 of them exploded, 2 of them not exploded, so you have to mark everything. Okay, next, explosives should be stored and handled carefully. Okay, why? Because during the handling of the explosives, it may explode, so we have to be very careful while handling with the explosives, right? Next, detonators and explosives should not be kept together. Okay, what is mean by these detonators and explosives? Okay, you might have seen in movies, okay, explosives will be somewhere in the site, and near us one handle will be there. Okay, one handle will be there, if we press that handle, bomb will be exploded, right? You might have seen in some movies, right? Most of the olden movies, there will be this one. Okay, there will be one handle. Okay, if they press that handle, the bomb will get exploded, right? So the detonators and the explosives should not be kept together. By mistake, you have pressed the detonator, what will happen? It will explode near you only, right? So both will be kept aside. Okay, both should not be kept together. It should be kept far away from the detonator, right? Explosive should be kept far away. Next, cartridges should be handled with rubber or polythene gloves. Okay, what is mean by this? Cartridges. Okay, cartridges means explosives will have inside some chemicals, right? In bullet, what will be there? Okay, in bullet, explosive will be there. Okay, if you fire that one only, the bullet will go forward. Okay, just a minute. Okay, if it is a bullet, okay, inside the bullet some explosive will be there. Okay, anything, it may be a chemical or it may be anything. Okay, due to that only the bullet will get fired. Okay, in the same also, when you see crackers, inside crackers there will be something, right? that one is called cartridges, right? Next, a minimum of 10 boreholes is exploded at a time, and that also successively and not simultaneously. Okay, that should be fired successively and not simultaneously. What is mean by successively and not simultaneously? Okay, if you see, you have placed 10 boreholes. Okay, you have placed 10 boreholes. Okay, you have to explode one after the other. Okay, you have exploded first borehole, next second borehole, third borehole. Okay, like this, successively, one after the other, not simultaneously. Okay, at a time we should not explode the 10 boreholes, right? So we should explode them in successively and not simultaneously. Is it clear? Yeah. These are the precautions that we have to take during the blasting of the blasting in the quarry, right? Is it clear? Next, dressing of stone. Okay, you have obtained the stone from the quarry. Now we have to shape that stone for the required purpose. Okay, if you are using that stone in your house, like a flooring purpose. So we have to dress that stone according to your purpose, right? Next, okay, if you are using that in your house, okay, if the stone is not in rectangle, perfect rectangle shape, okay, what we should do? We should take this chisel, okay? This is called chisel, right? The above one is hammer, okay? We have to mark a straight line and we have to hit that chisel with the hammer so that the stone will get break in a straight line. You see, he has marked a line, right? Is it clear? So according to that line only he will hit the hammer on the chisel, right? So that the stone will break in a rectangle shape, right? This process is called dressing of stone. Is it clear? Now we'll see. The dressing of stone is defined as the process of giving, okay, the process of giving a proper size, shape, and finish to the roughly broken stone. Okay, a big block of stone is there. Okay, big block of stone is there. Okay, now you have to give that stone a proper size, shape, and finish. Okay, you have to give that stone a proper size, shape, and finish. Is it clear? So the process of giving that stone a proper size, shape, and finish is called as dressing of stone. Okay, is it clear? Yeah, this process is done manually or mechanically. Okay, it may be done with humans or it may be done by machines. Okay, stone factories will be there. In the stone factories, big blades will be there. That blade will cut the stone in exact size and shape, and it can do finishing also. The finishing will be very, very smooth if it is a machine dressing, right? Yeah. Have you observed the flooring? Have you observed the flooring inside your house? Some may be having marble floors. Some may be having granite floors. Anything. If you observe that, the top surface is very smooth, right? How that smoothness is coming due to the dressing of the stone, right? Is it clear? Yeah. Okay, stones obtained from the quarry are very rough. Okay, it may be of any shape, right? It may be of any shape. It may be a rectangle, it may be a square, it may be having a undulations, anything, right? And irregular in shape and quite bulky in size and weight. Okay. If you have got a big block of stone, okay, first what we have to do, we have to break that block into small pieces. After small pieces, you have to dress the stone very neatly for the according to the purpose, right? Yeah. Next, what are the various objectives of dressing? Okay, now you have know about the dressing of stone, right? Now we'll see the property that we have left behind, right? Now we'll see that property. What is that property? Now you can understand what is that property and yeah, this is the last 12th property, ease in dressing. Okay, cost of dressing contributes to the cost of stone masonry. Okay, if you want a smooth surface, okay, you want a perfect rectangular stone, okay, if you want a designs on that stone, okay, what happen? The cost of dressing will increase, okay, right? If you want a more designs and all, the cost of dressing will be becoming more, right? Next, dressing is easy in stones with lesser strength. Okay, the dressing is easy in stones because by taking a chisel and beating with a hammer and making it a rectangular shape, it is very easy, right? Yeah, it is very easy, right? Next, hence an engineer should look into sufficient strength rather than high strength. Okay, so if a particular strength is required, okay, in our building, if 18 newtons is required, so that type of stone only we have to select. Okay, we should not select a high strength which is not required in our building, right? So engineer should look after into sufficient strength. Okay, if our house is requiring only 18 newtons of strength, okay, we have to use only sufficient strength. We should not go to high strength stones, right? So what happen if you go to high strength stone? Okay, what happen? The cost of the flooring also will increase, right? So we have to be very careful while selecting selecting the stone. Okay, yeah. Seasoning, we'll see seasoning here only. Okay, the stones obtained from quarry. Okay, the stones obtained from quarry. We have quarried a stone. Okay, that stone will contain moisture in the pores. Okay, the rock will contain the stone will contain small holes. Okay, small holes or pores. Is it clear? Small holes or pores. The strength of the stone improves if the moisture is removed. If we remove the moisture only, then only the strength of the stone will get improved. Okay, before using the stone, the process of removing moisture from stone is called seasoning. Okay, the process of removing moisture from pores is called seasoning. Okay, have you got about seasoning? Removal of the moisture from the pores is called seasoning. That's it. Is it clear? These are the properties. And now we will see. What are the various objectives of dressing, right? To reduce the size of the big blocks of stones. Okay, so that they are converted into easy liftable places. Okay, if a big block is there of a size of 24 meters, depth is 3.7 meters, right? Width also somewhat more. Okay, it will be very difficult to lift that block, right? So that we should reduce the size of that big block. Okay, to reduce the size of the big block, okay, we have to do dressing for that big block. After dressing, the big block will be converted into small pieces. So the small pieces can be easy to lift and keep at any place, right? This reduction in size is generally carried out at the quarry itself. Okay, this reduction in size is generally carried out at the quarry itself. So where they are doing this dressing process, okay, they are doing the dressing process in the quarry itself, right? They are doing the dressing process in the quarry itself, right? They are breaking the big block into small pieces at the quarry itself, right? Because that saves a lot of transportation cost, right? Carrying a big block will be requiring a lot of power, right? If that big block is converted into small pieces, so we can easily lift that pieces and we can transport that to any place, right? So first objective is to reduce the size of the big blocks into small liftable pieces, right? Is it clear? That is the first objective. Next, to give a proper shape to the stone, okay, we should give a proper shape to the stone. We are dressing that stone, okay? By dressing, we can give a proper shape to the stone, right? It is known that stones can be used at different places in the building. Okay, stone can be used in the different places of building. So we have to give a proper shape. Okay, if we are using in foundation, okay, if we are using that stone in the foundation, okay, how the foundation stone should be? It should be in a rectangular shape or in square shape, right? It should not be in a irregular shape. So for getting a rectangular shape or square shape, we can easily using that chisel, we can hit with a hammer, we can make into a proper shape, right? Next, in which places we can use that stone? Means foundation, walls, arches, right? Flooring. Okay, each situation will require a proper shape. Okay, in foundation it may require a rectangular shape. Okay, in wall also it may require a rectangular shape. But in arches you require a curved shape. Okay, in arches you require a somewhat curved shape. And in flooring, what type of shape we require? A rectangle or a square shape. Okay, most of the houses you see, there will be square pieces of marbles. Okay, if you are having a granite, rectangular shape of granite, right? Big block will be there in rectangular shape, granite, right? So each situation will require a proper shape. To give that proper shape, we have to do dressing. This is the another objective. And the third objective, okay, what is the third objective? To obtain an appealing finish, okay, to get a good finish, this dressing is required. In a residential building, stones are used not only because of extra strength, hardness and durability, but also because of their aesthetic value. Okay, if you see, take marble, it is somewhat cheaper than granite. Right, it is somewhat cheaper than granite. So if you just check the marble and granite, how is the finishing of the marble and the granite? Okay, the granite will have a crystalline structure, right? Crystalline glossy finish. Okay, it will be some shining. Okay, but what happens in marble? The marble will not shine that much. So dressing is required to give an appealing finish to the stone, right. Next, stone surfaces can be made very decorative and of attractive appearances, which will last for a considerable time. Okay, stone surfaces can be made into very decorative appearance, right? How we can make a rectangle, a triangular triangle portions. Okay, this is a triangle, right? And by making this triangle in four directions, we'll make some aesthetic views. So like this, designs will be very much more. So it will give a decorative surface to the flooring. Okay, and it will last for a considerable time. Okay, it will last up to how many days the house will be there, the flooring will be like that only, right? Is it clear? Right, that is the third objective. Okay, first objective to reduce the size of the big block, and the second objective to give a proper shape to the stone, and the third objective to obtain a appealing finish, right? Yeah. Okay, if you are having any doubts up to here, you may ask. Okay, in the next session, I will be providing the Google sheet. So in the next session, you fill the Google form, your attendance. Okay, please attend the next session and you will get the attendance. Okay, after filling the attendance, you can do whatever. Okay, up to here, if you are having any doubt, means you can ask. What are the remaining topics, methods or types of dressings? Okay, only one topic is there left in this chapter. Okay, in the next session, we will see that types of dressing of stone. Okay, in the next session, I'll be providing the link, okay? Okay, join the next session and submit your attendance. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Sorry, I have forgotten. Yesterday I said I'll give at 5 p.m. right? So today brick and stone. Okay, both topics I will send. Okay, immediately after the finishing of the class. Okay. So with this. After the completion of this types of dressing, your stones chapter also will get completed. Is it clear? Okay. Just check, study the subject, and if you are having any doubts, please ask. Okay. Every day I am asking if you are having any doubts or not. Right. Okay. Join the next session. Okay.